That finger-picked acoustic riff you just heard me play applies three different finger-picking patterns. Now, those patterns make up a collection of some of the most popular acoustic fingerstyle guitar plucking patterns commonly used in hundreds, if not thousands, of songs. So in this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to perform each one of them. But first, before we get started, a quick word about my handouts collection ebook offer. Do you want an amazing guitar book that's perfect for any guitarist at any level? Well, here's how to get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection eBook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson eBook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations to donate and download your copy today. The first finger picking pattern I have for you sounds like this. Now this pattern starts on a quarter note and then continues with straight eighth notes. The string set layout applies a low bass tone in the beginning on that third fret of fifth string, C. And then what happens is when the run kicks in, it's a continuation of the C major chord that I already have set up on the fretting hand. And all we're going to do is go into the fourth string, second fret, E note, and then third string open. We'll carry on back to the fifth string root of C on third fret. And then we'll jump across to the second string, first fret, C. So we're taking care of an octave there. And then we're going to go inside on the fourth and third strings and get an E note to a G third string open. So with the quarter note up front, remember you got to give it a little bit of a delay there because it's going to take up the full first beat, and then after that everything is continuous in eighth notes. So the counting of it overall would be 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1. Now for the finger picking hand, it's a really important concept here that we want to attend to, because in the finger style approach, you want to have your hand loose, relaxed. You don't want to be anchoring. You know, I hate to see people anchoring because it puts a lot of stress on that plucking hand. Just keep your hand relaxed, center your thumb where it needs to be, in this case fifth string, and then from there we're going to focus on index middle for the fourth and third strings, back to thumb over to the ring finger for that second string, and then just index and middle again to take care of those last two notes. So it's just thumb, index, middle, thumb, ring, index, middle. All right, so that's finger picking pattern number one. All right, let's jump over to finger picking pattern number two. This is a continuous eighth note groove, and on a C major chord, it sounds like this. So it's very busy sounding because it's so continuous in the way it's set up. We're starting on the fifth string, third fret, and then we're going over to the second string at the first fret. So we're jumping across an octave there. Then we're going to the inside of the chord, and we're going to take care of that E note to the G third string open. We'll head back at that point, going to the low C, and then an E note, and then a G third string open, returning back again to the E note on the second fret of fourth string. So that last part of it off of the fourth beat is just moving up across the chord, three notes, and then back. So all together, we got this. Now for the right hand, for the plucking hand, what we're doing is we're getting that bass note with our thumb. Ring finger is plucking on that second string, and then we're going on the inside with index and middle, back to the low tone with our thumb, index, middle on the fourth and third strings, back to index on the fourth string, second fret. So the plucking hand, when it's set up, you can tell already, just going through these first two picking patterns, it needs to be well aligned and well situated on those string sets that it's going to be attending to. And that doesn't matter whether it's this chord or it's other chords that you're going to move this shape to, because this chord, let's say moving to an A minor, it's not going to be much different in the setup of how things are organized, because you can just track the same string sets. For that matter, even doing an A major, same kind of thing. any chord that's going to be set up on those same string sets will be just like that. You know, a lot of times if you're doing, let's say, a G chord, though, you know, setting up a G chord is going to be a little bit different because now we're going to be skipping a string. So you have to organize it, first of all, and get it organized for the chord that we're dealing with here, which is C major. And then once you've got that done and you understand it fully and completely, then, of course, you can start taking it to other chords. You know, whether it's a top four guitar strings that you're going to be using, let's say maybe a D major. The systematic, you know, run through of it, how it's all set up, it's going to be the same, but you just have to understand how it, you know, goes over to a new chord type. It's not hard to do, and, you know, it's really valuable to look at one chord in the beginning. We're just using C major here. Get it down 100%, and then you can start shifting it to other chords. If you're a Patreon member, you're going to get a handout for this, and everything will be in detail so you can fully understand it. You know, just print it out and, you know, put it up on your music stand at home and, you know, go through it step by step. But, hey, I got one more pattern for you, and this one's really nice. It's going to use some more quarter note feel. Check this out. So you could tell up front on the first two hits, we're dealing with the downbeat of one and the downbeat of two, and they're just performed as quarter notes, so it's kind of like one, two. Now what's really cool about that second beat is we're doing a double pluck there. We're grabbing both the E note and the C note on fourth string to second string. I'm using my index finger and ring finger to do that double pluck. It's a kind of a unique idea there, so off the bass note in the beginning with my thumb, I'm moving over to that double plucked E and C. And then from there, what we're going to do is kind of like cascade, you know, across the strings a little bit with some string skipping, because we're going to be going through the C chord from the C on the third fret of the fifth string into an open third string G note. And then we're going to double back and we're going to get an E note on the second fret of fourth string, and then a C high up on top there, first fret, second string, C. And the patterning for the right hand, for the plucking hand, is going to be thumb, middle, index, and ring to take care of that staggered group of tones there. Put it all together, you got a really nice idea that's half quarter notes up front on the first two beats, and then a remainder, really interesting staggered, you know, almost arpeggiated sound when we get to those eighth notes at the third and fourth beats. All right, guys, that's the three finger picking patterns. You probably recognize them maybe if you, you know, like Fleetwood Mac, or maybe even at the beginning of a Bon Jovi song or something where, you know, you'll have some acoustic guitar, maybe even other rock tunes. You know, there's a lot of songs out there, even in the rock world, classic rock, that begin with some nice acoustic guitar finger picking. And the sound overall, you know, if you like, you know, really laid back stuff, check out William Ackerman, you know, all the acoustic players out there. Don Ross is another guy. You just got to hear him. Fantastic fingerstyle player. But there's tons and tons of them out there. Really listen closely to the patternings that they use. There's a lot of similarities there. If you know these three, you're going to be able to cut through a lot of different tunes out there. And hey, you know, the really fun thing is you can make up some of your own music as well. Use these to come up with some of your own original compositions. It's really a lot of fun. And guys, if you want to get the handout, check out my Patreon. It's over at patreon.com/creative guitar studio. I got tons of lessons over there. I've been doing Patreon for many years now. There's hundreds of lessons, in fact, over on my Patreon page. So you can check that out. This is part of the Friday Patreon Plus release. It means any tier gets this, $3, $5, $15. All you guys get this one. And then, hey, if you guys want to learn, you know, more about acoustic guitar, I've got a full acoustic guitar course over at my website. It's a different website aside from Patreon. It's over at creativeguitarstudio.com, and all of my courses over there as well. So if you want to study an introductory, intermediate, advanced, bunch of other electives that I've got over there, the rhythm guitar program, ear training, music reading, guitar technique, guitar soloing, there's tons of stuff over there. Go and check it out. You're going to love it. Plus, there's a ton, and I mean a ton, of free lessons over on that website. So go and sign up as a free member and check out everything there. You're going to love it. It's at creativeguitarstudio.com. Once again, the handout for this lesson is on my Patreon page at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. Learning acoustic guitar finger picking patterns like these will help get you one step closer to becoming the best guitar player that you can be. To learn more, sign up for a free membership today at creativeguitarstudio.com. I have over 30 years experience teaching guitar, and I've written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to learn the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player you can be.